Hello, I am David Kaplan, and I am not an expert. But I hope in this series to learn as much as possible and explain it to you the best way I can. What happens when you fall into a black hole? We do not know. If you believe Einstein's theory of relativity, we do know. The person falling into the black hole crosses the horizon of the black hole, and if the black hole is big enough, the person doesn't notice. They just keep on going. And if they get close enough to the singularity at the center of the black hole, bad things happen to their body. They get stretched out and warped, and the gravity is so strong that it's very bad. So we do have a description in that theory. On the other hand, in quantum mechanics, if you have a situation where there is a horizon, a surface where nothing can come out from behind it, then quantum fluctuations at that horizon produce radiation, and the radiation comes out, and you could measure that in principle. But if that energy is coming out of the black hole, even from just the horizon, the black hole should shrink and eventually disappear. And whatever had fallen into the black hole essentially disappears. And the confusing thing is that quantum mechanics doesn't predict the disappearance of any information. And so we would like to understand how the information that went into the black hole comes back out. And that requires describing the inside of a black hole. But that means that the theory of general relativity, which predicts nothing interesting happening at the horizon, smells like it's in contradiction with the theory of quantum mechanics, which suggests that the horizon is a very important place. So there's no complete description of the interior of the black hole, which means we don't know what happens. We don't really care about what happens to somebody who falls in. What we care about is attempting to describe quantum mechanics and general relativity in the same theory, and a black hole is the perfect place because it requires both.